por ti, tú por mí.
Yo por ti, tú por mí. Yo por ti, tú por mí. Yo por ti, tú por mí.
Una lurilla te.
Mami.
Colgando del cuello los juguetes.
Del cuello los juguetes.
Rodeado de flores y billetes. Y mira, 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 si con nosotros te entromete. No quieres que lo, que lo, que lo. Me da igual si tu amor me compromete.
Me da igual.
Contigo puesto que el número 7.
7, 7.
Si me entrego que tú me sujetes.
Please.
Yo por ti, tú por mí, que me ponga los grilletes.
Los grilletes.
Somos dos cantantes como los de antes. Boletos y diamantes. Se me para el corazón solo con mirarte. Porque a ti te canto pa' que tú me cantes.
Somos dos cantantes como los de antes. El respeto en boletos y...
It's a privilege to be here today for this very special fixture. Every time they meet each other, these two teams, it is a very special day. Hopefully it lives up to the billing. Join us for the kickoff, and it's live. Martin Tyler here, welcoming you to the San Siro Stadium, along with Alan Smith, of course, because it is the day of the derby. Milan against Inter, all that that entails, all the history, and another chapter to be written over the next 90 minutes.
Can't wait for it. No surprise, this place is packed to the rafters. Such steep stands make for a wonderful atmosphere. It's going to be no different today.
This is the Milan lineup. Gianluigi Donnarumma is the goalkeeper. Lucas Piszczek starts alongside Teo Hernandez in defence. Suso plays with Fabio Barini in the wide positions. And here is just the one main attacker in this lineup. Piszczek. Bonaventura. Milivojevic. Rebic. Trying to turn over the play here. Rebic. Now they can launch a counter-attack. Oh, mistake by the goalkeeper. Could make a chance with this tackle. He's won it back easily. And he moved from Everton to Manchester United. He got 27 goals in that first season, 17-18, Romelu Lukaku.
Yeah, he's a student of the game, always looking to improve.
This is Inter's lineup. Sami Handanovic starts in goal. Dalbert plays alongside Milan Skriniar in defence. And the last player on the team sheet is the one main forward. Martinez. Well, both the Milan clubs have had their ups and downs in a topsy-turvy time for Italian football, but they still stand for so much that's good about football in this country, Alan.
Well, they certainly do. The heritage, the tradition involved in this derby, San Siro. What a sight it is walking towards it.
Well, the ball's been deflected out, so it'll be a throw-in. Suso. Rebic. Nicola Barella, a chance to break away now on the counter. Breaks still on. They've made the defenders turn here with that pass. The referee looks to his assistant, who's got the flag up, it's offside. Here's Politano.
Odriozola.
Probing pass. Lukaku! He's gone for the volley, and it nearly paid off.
Yeah, really good technique there. Known for that kind of volley.
A good control under pressure.
From Kessie.
Fabio Borini.
Rebic. Rebic.
Keeper has reached it and rescued his side.
It's
just doesn't happen overnight, this kind of pressing, and it's working well for them, showing how much they've put into their training sessions. I think he rushed his shot there, and that's why it's so wide of the mark. He's going to get a yellow here. That's the earlier incident, and the ref's got it absolutely right.
Yeah, hands up. He knows that booking was coming his way.
Nicola Barella. Here's Dalbert. Dalbert. They're looking good when they attack. Fabio Borini. It's always a privilege, I feel, to commentate on the Milan clubs. You know, they've given so much to the game. Undoubtedly, that
in with a chance,
decent opportunity there, but it was easy in the end for the goalkeeper.
Well, I don't know what was wrong there, whether he took his eye off the ball, he certainly didn't connect with it how he should have.
Lukaku, very good tackle. Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take him on like this. Got his foot in to cut out the pass. Rebic! Brilliant goal!
Just before half-time, and they will be delighted with that. They haven't played badly, but haven't created too much.
Great news for Milan, they're in front. And the verdict on added time is 2 minutes. Now, can they make this count? Keeping the ball
to bring them level. The last line of defence.
So it's 1-0 here as the half-time whistle goes. I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
Yeah, and what a good time to score that was. Put his side in the lead.
Second period to come now, and Inter on the ball. Here's Dalbert. Nicola Barella.
Odriozola.
Barella. Martinez. Trying to stretch the opposition using the wider areas here. Trying to pass their way into position to level the game. Milan going to make a substitution here. They're going to take off the forward. Forwards, as often is the case, being substituted. One goal, he might have thought with the time left he might get more, but he's happy to get the one, I'm sure.
Yeah, and it was a well-taken goal and a really good performance from him, I thought. Really solid.
Politano. Striding forward, purposefully. Coming up on EA Sports, of course, the Serie A fixture coming up for Milan. They'll be facing Torino away from home.
Well, you know there'll be fireworks between these two teams. Can't wait to get up on the gantry for this one.
Just to return to the subject of Inter, and there is a real sense of football history when we get to see them play. We could be in. Martinez, pushed out for the goal. Goal for Inter.
Oh, I always used to love scoring these type of goals when you're there first. It feels good, this.
A good look here again by the replay of the goal.
Great news for the manager, because I think he made a couple of changes there, and now they're back on level terms.
So away we go at 1-1. Substitution for Milan. This does look promising. Chance to put it in the box from here.
You can see what he was trying to do, but the defender in the way.
As for Inter, what about their next game, Alan?
They're playing Lazio in their next match, and I do think whoever scores first is going to win this tight one.
Well, a move for a good player to the lovely city of Seville to play for Real Betis. That deal is now confirmed.
They've signed a young and...
Let's take the lead here! Now here's a chance from winning the ball. It's a very good clearance, and it was needed. Still 20 minutes to go. It's with the Politano. How are they going to build from here, Inter? Now they've got it out wide. It's a good cross.
We had a chance, really, to put that into a much more dangerous area. Has to go down as a poor cross.
In goes the corner. Ljubojevic. One off, one on for Milan. Martinez. Bit of interplay for Inter out wide. What a chance to take the lead. Oh, what a happy goal scorer. He's found the way past the keeper once already, and now he's knocked in his second, and the hat-trick is definitely on for him.
A goal from Lukaku, and there was a gap to the keeper's left, and he found that with real power.
Well, Milan have gone behind there. Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left. We're getting down to the wire here, and Milan might find that it's barbed wire at the end.
Well, the San Siro is trying to help here, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough.
Good distance to the clearance then. Pronkesie, Bonaventura, threading it through. Suso. The keeper stops it. It's another chapter in the story of this rivalry. They've got a late equaliser now.
Well, I don't think he'll have to buy a meal for the rest of his life in this town, having scored there.
Extraordinary game here. Two very well-matched teams, and they're trading goal for goal in the game. Difficult for the defender against the player who wants to take... This could be a chance. Oh, he's been called offside here. Nicola Barella. Martinez. Referee's had a good look and decided, from what he's seen from this period of play, to add on 3 minutes.
On Milan, they've upped the intensity in these latter stages. Looking likely to get a late winner, and the crowd are demanding it.
Guiding it through. I think he saved them there with that interception. That's it, level pegging between the two.
I swear daylight comes too soon. After party, everyone rolls through. Don't matter where I go, as long as I go with you. I swear daylight comes too soon.
Anzitutto la ringrazio per aver accettato di rispondere alle nostre domande. Grazie ancora per il suo tempo.
We are at the San Siro Stadium today. Delighted to have you with us. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. Our action is from Serie A. It's coming right up. It's Inter against Lazio.
I think if we get a nice, sharp, quick tempo to begin with, we're in for a real treat here because we've got a couple of entertaining sides that love to go forward.
A couple of exceptional talents in a really good game that we might be focusing on.
Well, two excellent attacking players we are treated to seeing. They're really enjoying good seasons and I'm expecting a bit more of the same today.
Game underway. First half started by Inter. Inter make one change. Samir Handanovic starts in goal. Diego Godin starts, looking to continue his good form at the back. And just one out-and-out attacker in the lineup. Front now. Well, he has started fast and they've started fast. That's the opening goal.
So it's a goal that's put Lazio into the lead.
Marušić. Marco Pirollo. Well, there have been some awkward times for Milan recently. One thing that's never, never decreased.
Looking for a through ball.
Kept his concentration, the goalkeeper, and because of that, kept hold of the ball.
Yeah, he seems to feel the goal, this lad. He's quite an imposing keeper.
Milinkovic-Savic.
And on the subject of Milan, the ground, Giuseppe Meazza Stadium, I think is the official title of it. It is one of the places, the football temples, if you like, to visit.
It is, it's a must-see. On your European tour, and they had problems with the pitch at one stage, but not so much now. They're disgusted, aren't they, the fans, that the ref hasn't pointed to the spot there.
That's neatly done. Good challenge by the defender, very good control.
Lukaku!
It's bounced back off the bar.
This could bring them level, and it does! Important point in the game.
Well, what a game changer that might be. I think the momentum's just shifted.
It is level. Both sides have scored here now. Promising forward play from them again. Adam Marušić. Certainly playing well enough to get their noses in front here. Marušić. He could take them on here. Room for the cross. Delivery to the far post. Out in front of goal. Spotted that well and intercepted. Martinez. Chance to get the ball in the box. Romelu Lukaku. It's a very good clearance, and it was needed. So the corner to come. And in it goes. Well, that's straight at the goalkeeper, and the attacking team will be annoyed with that. Well, there's some drama in the game being watched by our good friend Alan McInally. A sending off, I believe. Alan.
It's a red card for the home team. They're down to 10 men. 35 minutes played. It remains 1-0.
Oh, interesting news again from Alan McInally. Thanks, Alan. He's got a chance to cross. Lukaku saw the direction of the pass. Didn't want the referee to blow his whistle, and he hasn't.
So often you see it, it's a bad tackle, and he...
With great vision here. Caicedo, and he dives in, goal! It was a move to make your mouth water. Great goal.
It's come in from a long way out, and from that angle, it's not always easy to finish.
Defenders caught out by it in the end. Correa. Good interception. Well, they're getting the ball forward. They need to do that. It's with the Politano. And that's the referee's decision. Two added minutes.
It's good play, this. The opposition can't get at them when they're keeping the ball.
Brozovic.
Brozovic!
Oh, he's kept it out. Corner played in. Turned aside there by the keeper. Well, the referee is blown for half-time. And this is the start of the second half here at the San Siro. Lukaku. Alexis Sanchez. Good one-on-one defending with the tackle. We'll get an update here from Alan McInally about a goal in the Parma match.
It's a second goal for the visitors. 49 minutes played. 2-0.
And we're back here again, thanks to Alan McInally. And that first half with an outstanding contribution from Romelu Lukaku.
Nothing wrong with his finishing on that goal. And very nearly added a second. Hitting the woodwork, though.
And back it goes to the back of his heel. Neatly done. On EA Sports, very soon, a date for your diary. The Serie A fixture. Inter, they'll be facing Sampdoria away from home.
Yeah, an important 3 points coming up for grabs here. Can't wait for it.
Vecino. It's a good pass in behind the defenders. And that counts for Inter.
That is a joy to behold. It's just floated up into that top right-hand corner.
Well, it's level again in the match. What a roller coaster ride it's been. Just a mistake, really. He's not even asked too much of the opponent. It's just a mishit pass. Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes. Half an hour to go. Romelu Lukaku. Do you have any thoughts about Lazio's next game, Alan?
Well, they're playing Genoa in the next match in Serie A.
And I can only see one winner, I think now, Costa.
With Napolitano. Lautaro Martinez.
Might just be in here from that little chip pass.
And they've scored, they've taken the lead.
Inter with the goal here.
Well, he's got a track record of that. On his left side, he's so dangerous.
Let's have another peek at that goal. Lazio at the kickoff, having conceded the goal.
Berisha. He's got good support in the middle if he gets his cross in.
That was catching practice for the goalkeeper. Good piece of tackling there. Lovely ball. The men in the middle frustrated because that... Cross has gone straight behind. Nicola Barella. Lukaku. Brozovic.
Brozovic! It looked a certain goal until the defender managed to get some contact.
That's just instinct, but that is top defended.
No nonsense defending from him. Now Milinkovic-Savic. Now Skriniar. And it's going to be his throw here. There's been plenty of warming up going on, and now I think one of the substitutes will be brought into the game.
Well, this is fascinating, and the crowd are loving the drama that we're watching here. Just a one goal in it in favour of the home team.
Yeah, careful that they don't start celebrating too quickly and that the players feel they've won the game before they actually have.
Lukaku!
Lukaku! Two for him today, and his team are benefiting from his sharpness in front of goal, knocking the ball into the back of the net.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal. And he took it in excellent style, just like the first one. Well, when you have the quality and the width, that's what this lad brings, you've got a special talent. And it's been a special showing as he's replaced now, the crowd recognising that.
Yeah, what he's done, he's hugged the touchline and he's stretched that opposing back line, created space for teammates inside, and vital performance from him.
Now, we've only got 4 minutes remaining in the match.
Odriozola.
Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. Luis Alberto.
Referee has chosen to add on 2 extra minutes.
Well, this could be a chance from the ball played over the top.
Antonio Candreva.
And it's come to an end now as the referee...
lipstick you like glue. Young girls ways, now you don't know, you don't shoot. All these old men cannot tell me what to do. Oh, 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 oh.
What a lovely day for football. Welcome to you all. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. Our football comes from Serie A. It's Sampdoria against Inter.
Yeah, thanks, Martin. Well, we've got a couple of teams here that their strengths are attacking, no doubt about it. So I'm sure they'll be going at each other very quickly.
It's poor work, really. Good pressure in midfield and it's paid off. Taking on the defenders. Qualiarella! Goalkeeper comes up trumps again, Samir Handanovic.
I thought he was wrong-footed, but no, he adjusts brilliantly.
In goes the corner.
And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one.
Needed.
Well, he certainly wasn't basking in the glory of the first save. The game continued. Oh, you know what goalkeepers are like. He's probably disappointed it was such a simple second save. But he certainly showed us what he's got a few moments earlier.
Yeah, no wonder his team, Mac.
Really in the clear now, in on goal.
What a Valero! Well, they've gone for it right from the off, and they've got their reward with an early opening goal here.
That is a wonderful goal, Alan.
The defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out.
Inter have the lead here. Fabio Qualiarella. Qualiarella.
Probing away, working away at the opposition with these passes.
Too close to the keeper in the end.
Well, just checking on the table, we can confirm what you know already, of course, that 3 points would be enough for the visiting team here to go top.
You're right, it's early days, Martin, but they've started the season really well. They'll certainly want...
It's a good hit!
And the goalkeeper can maybe think about starting an attack.
Borja Valero. Dangerous pass, I think, with the keeper pushing it away.
News from the Napoli match from Alan McAnally about, I believe, a goal.
It's a goal for Napoli. It's been scored by Dries Mertens. Rather fortunate to have a long-range effort come off a defender and leave the keeper marooned. 22 minutes played, 1-0.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual.
Good reading of the play, anticipating the pass.
It's a very good interception.
Batshuayi. Looking for a through ball. Now, just a keeper to beat.
And the referee looks to his assistant, who's got the flag up, it's offside.
Bamba. Borja Valero.
Shot on!
Well, the keeper's got that.
We're hearing there's been a goal in the Napoli match, and Alan McAnally is there. Alan, quickly update us.
It's a second goal for Napoli. It's been scored by Dries Mertens. It looked as though the keeper might...
Vecino!
Now, the keeper's done well to keep that one out. That brief news from Alan McAnally. It was a bit too short. That was my fault, I'm afraid. Cut across him. A Napoli goal. The score is now 2-0.
Well, here we are with the countdown on to half-time now, and a full 45 minutes to play in the second half, in which Inter might have to work extremely hard to stay in front. From what we've seen so far, that is the suggestion.
Linetti. Encouraging play from this team now, keeping the ball.
Got a chance to cross.
2 more minutes to be played then, added time. Michy Batshuayi. Nicola Barella. Batshuayi. One or two options now in forward areas for them.
And then he went, just diverted it away.
Well, the referee has signaled for half-time, and it's 1-0 here. Inter are the team that really dominated the first half. They got the lead. Second half now is underway. Diego Godin.
Dalbert. Nicola Barella.
Play on is the message for Inter with the advantage rule. And this is going to be an interesting decision from the referee, San Milano.
Clearly a booking. Out comes the yellow card.
Well, he reached straight for his pocket. He didn't really think about it, but I think that's the good call.
Defender did well to get to it, but that
could be a game-winning moment to go two in front now.
The goal from Candreva, and he's just shaped his body there beautifully to stroke it into the bottom left.
Restarting at 2-0. EA Sports coverage to come from Italy, the Serie A fixture Sampdoria. They'll be facing Verona away from home.
Yeah, an important 3 points coming up for grabs here. Can't wait for it.
Inter now looking for some attacking inspiration. Chance to put it in the box from here. Danger was looming large, but they've got themselves back on the ball.
And on the home bench, a substitute is clearly getting ready to come on. As for Inter, what about their next game, Alan?
Yeah, they're playing Barcelona, aren't they? In their next...
Crafting the through pass.
That's an important clearance. Barella. I've got his angles wrong with the pass.
Striding forward, purposefully.
Well, now they're behind. They've got to try and switch things around. And here comes a substitution.
A couple of teammates up in support. Keeper's ball.
No question about that. It was a weak cross, really.
Borja Valero. That's an unforced error, really, with the pass. Caprari.
Bright idea, but he couldn't manufacture the pass that would have got his teammate away and in on goal.
Antonio Candreva. Good width in the attack here, looking for a cross at the end of it.
Inter get the throw. It is going to be a change here. And it looks like a strategic one.
Borja Valero.
Good one-on-one defending with the tackle. Murillo. Ferrari. Jakub Jankto. Rigoni. Teammates getting out of the way because they know he can dribble it here. Jankto.
Time to get the ball in.
Excellent movement to get the pass and stay onside. cleared the ball. News from the Napoli match from Alan McAnally about, I believe, a goal.
It's a third goal for Napoli. It's been scored by Amin Younes. A lovely goal from the edge of the box that swung in. To the top corner, 78 minutes played, 3-0.
Top work, Alan. We're back here now with Alan Smith. A sub coming on for Inter.
Space to try and hit it now. A really close, great technique there.
Oh, there's no finer sight than when you get that right. Unlucky.
Counting down towards the end of the 90 minutes, 9 minutes left. Ferrari. Oh, he's won it back. That's a really good tackle. Caprari. Saw it coming. Cut it out. Good work. And back it goes to the...
He's got to...
Oh, mistake by the goalkeeper.
They have scored, and there is still maybe time on the clock for them to go again. That's what they'll be hoping for, rushing back to the centre circle to get the game restarted.
And we restart the game 2-1. 2 minutes of added time. That's what it says on the board. Bamba. And the offside is given. Cross is blocked. Just 1 minute left on the clock. Borja Valero. And it's come to an end now as the referee calls a halt. Well, sometimes you get it.
Come on in, you letting out all the cold air, bro. Where you been? I know that you ain't.